Hey, all viewers. So we've come to an end. The response for this TwinCAT 3 tutorial has been light years beyond my imagination. I've had many people contacting and thanking me, and it makes me very happy to know that others find my work useful. That makes me really, really happy. One of my personal goals of this tutorial has been that I also wanted to learn something new. As this has mostly been a one-man show, I didn't only need to think about the actual content of this tutorial, but also about all aspects of content creation. This includes, amongst many other things, stuff like, you know, light control and manuscript writing, video recording like I'm doing now, video cutting and editing, image processing, sound recording and, yeah, sound adjustment stuff. And it was just much, much more than that. As I've probably already told you, the learning process is where the fun is at. And who could have known that being a content creator is so much fun? It's really, really fun to make videos. And software engineering, that's just my biggest passion in life. I'm extremely, extremely, extremely happy that I can work with something that I truly, truly love. And yeah, I mean, that's one of the goals of these videos, to share this passion and the wonders of PLC software development with you. And I hope that this resource will motivate you to pass on this and any other future knowledge to others. There is, unfortunately, a lot of knowledge hoarding in the automation industry, you know, where people don't want to share their knowledge for one reason or another. It happens. I've seen it quite often. Not everywhere. I'm optimistic, however, and I'm sure this will change in the future. And I hope that you will be contributing and sharing your knowledge with others. I want to take the opportunity here and give my parents a big thank you for buying me a computer when I was just a small kid. I mean, it wasn't a particularly powerful computer or anything, but it was enough to learn on. And yeah, I mean, I had to shata, what's that? Shata in Swedish. Nag. I had to nag on them for several months, but eventually they gave in and bought me a computer. So to my mom and dad, to finally agree and buy me a computer was one of the best decisions of your life. And I also want to thank my wife for standing out with me when I constantly had to spend evenings after work and weekends and holidays and vacation and, yeah, just recording and doing video editing, everything except being with her. So yeah, I really want to thank her for that. And I also want to thank her for doing all the German subtitles, because my German is nicht so gut, so to speak. And I think actually we should bring her in so that you will meet her. Betsy, can you come?
Okay, you can come here if you want to. You can sit here.
Hello there.
Hi, viewers. Hello, Jakob.
Thank you very much for coming here. First, I just wanted to say vielen Dank für die Untertitelung.
Kein Problem. Can I say something to your viewers?
Yeah.
Okay. Hello, viewers. I think I can say better than anybody else that Jakob has really been putting his heart and soul into these videos and a lot of time. So I just want to thank you for all your likes, the subscriptions, the members, the patrons, the nice comments that Jakob has been getting over the last 1.5 years for his content, because I think he is really getting the recognition he deserves, and that makes me very happy and very thankful to you. Goodbye.
Thank you, my love. That's very kind of you.
It's very kind of your viewers.
Thank you very much, my love, for coming here.
Thanks for having me.
Okay, bye-bye.
See you later.
I hope that you have found this tutorial useful and that this will only be the start of your journey. My recommendation for you as a next step is to get your hands dirty and work on a real-life project. I mean, theory can only get you so far. You will learn much, much more once you get out in the real world, writing software for and troubleshooting real machines, and you get involved in all the other aspects of working with industrial automation, like, you know, working with electrical stuff and mechanical stuff, and yeah, I mean, the operator perspective of it, that's really important as well. So all we've been talking so far throughout this series of videos has only been one tiny, 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 tiny piece of the cake, so to speak. it's when you work on real projects with real machines that your learning curve is going to get exponential. Oh, that's a tricky English word. That's the disadvantage of not being a native English speaker. Exponential, you know, the curve straight up. Anyway, good luck on your future PLC programming career, and thank you very much for watching.